Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach the subject employability and skill development. Up till we discussed from this subject up to unit number 3, and unit number 4 we started, and that unit number 4's title is the grammar and comprehension. First unit we discussed one as the English sentences and phrases. From this fourth unit we already discussed this point, but today once again I am repeating this point in this today's lecture, that English sentences and phrases. The first is the English sentences. See, whenever we are using any language, we are using the words to build the sentence. That may be in a group of words which having the meaning, or we can say that it is giving the sense of that particular word. The words which are used in a groups which is giving the sense of that thing, it is called as the sentence. That means sentence, it can be built by using, or we are building that particular sentence by using n number of words, and that words it is having some kind of a sense, right? And that is a some kind of a sense. This sense giving the exactly the meaning of that particular sentence. This sense, it is giving the meaning of that particular sentence by using the different kinds of the words. That maybe we are using that words maybe in the groups, in the having the separate words, or in a different manner. Now, as per the consideration, or you can say that group of words, whatever we are making the sentence, this sentence having the four kinds. First one is the, we can say that sentence it is having the statements, or it is in the form of the, you can say that assertions, statements or assertion. We can give the example as the Humpty Dumpty sat on a well, sat on a vote. This it is having some sort of the, you can see that statement. This sentence it is having the one kind of a statement. This is the first kind. Second one is the we are asking questions. Who are you? For example, who are you? That means questionary type sentence, it is the second kind of a sentence. Third one is the, we are using some sort of the commands to express that sentence, or we can say that request, we are making request. That means commands, request. Okay, such a words which are used to build up the sentence, this is called as a third kind of a sentence. Now, fourth one is the feeling. The sentence which is expressing the feeling, that kind of a this kind of a sentence is the fourth kind of a sentence of that English. So, what a shame! That is a one kind of a feeling. Or how called the this 90s, or we can say that today's there is a very hot. That means the feeling which is expressed in that sentence, this is the one kind of a sentence. So according to the kinds of this particular sentence, these kinds, or whatever we are built up in the sentence, these kinds can be again called in a different, you can see that manner. So first I already discussed that the first sentence is the statement kind. This statement kind sentence or assertion sentence, it is also called as the declarative or assertive sentence. It is also called as the declarative or assertive sentence. Second kind of sentence, which is we are calling as the we are using the questionary kind of a thing or words, that is called as the interrogative. Third kind of a sentence, which we are expressing or we are using some sort of the commands, not expressing, we are requesting, or which we are using the commands, this is called as the imperative sentence. And third one, in which we are expressing feeling, it is called as the explanatory sentence. Now then, how the sentence, or I already said that some kind of a words we are using or group of words we are using to build the sentence, then how it is you can say that made one or make one the or we can see that when we are making the sentence, at that time we are considering some sort of the persons or things. Persons in the sense, we are naming the person. Things in the sense, we are naming that particular thing. Pen, this is the pen. That means this is the one kind of a thing, and we are naming it as the pen. Likewise, person, I am, that means my name is Kuppadi, right? That means we are giving the name. So, and some kind time, what we are doing, whenever we are doing the sentence, at that time we are expressing or we are saying something about that particular person or that particular thing. For example, this pen can be used to write the things or write some sort of the, you can say that note, you can say that some doing the task, right? That means this is the subject of this particular, you can say that the thing which we are used for. That means whenever we are making the sentence, we are considering the thing's subject, and by using the thing's subject, we are developing the sentences by giving the some sort of, by using the some sort of the words, group of words, and exactly the subject for which that thing it is used one, right? That means today I am teaching, that means I am the some sort of the trainer or teacher. And what the teacher he is doing, he is giving some sort of the guideline, he is expressing the thoughts related to that particular points, whatever the knowledge he is having, he is explaining that thing. Like that, we are that means the teacher is the person, but for the thing, the subject is nothing but guideline or training, or it is he is giving that you can say that speech on that particular thing point, right? So to build the sentence, what we are using, the we are considering the that particular person, things, and the subject, which is we can say that perform or doing, or you can say that expressing the meaning of that particular sentence. The sentence, it is directly not that considered one. That means I have to write something, but whenever I am writing, whenever I am speaking, at that time I am using the proper words. I am making the group of words to explain that particular meaning of the sentence. Right, this is the exactly the sentence which is giving the meaning of that particular thing by using the number of words. Such a, you can see that things are used one which is predicting about that particular sentence, or you can see that which is giving some sort of the something about that particular subject thing, right? Right, that is called as a sentence. Some sentences, you can see that, for example, here comes the bus. That bus stand is there, or that particular point is there, that particular route, it is used by that particular bus. So that's why it is the sentence, it is made one. That means here the here bus comes, or here comes the bus, right? That is the thing. Like that, we are making the sentences by using that particular subject point of view, using the number of groups and the subject which is giving the exactly meaning of that particular sentence. Now, then what is mean by this particular phrases? What is mean by this particular phrases? If suppose I am using some sort of the sentence which is having the phrase, say for example, the sun rises in the east. The sun rises in the east. Right. The sun rises in the east. See, sun, obviously, it is a one kind of a thing, or we can say that like us, we are named as the sun. So, sun rises in the east, that means in the east, it is a phrase from that particular sentence. It is giving the complete sense of that particular word, sentence. This particular phrase, it is giving the complete sense. What the sense is that? Sun rises in the east. Sun rises. We are saying that sun rises. Where? In the east. That means in the east it is an important one. That is the, you can say that, that is the phrase. Which is, that means we can say that the phrase is nothing but which gives the sense in that particular sentence. Sense in that particular sentence. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Where they sat? They sat on the wall. On the wall, that is giving the sense of that particular sentence. Humpty Dumpty sat. It is not a complete sentence, which is not giving the entire meaning. Okay, it is some sort of the part of that particular sentence. But to give the sense of that particular sentence, then here we have to use some sort of the phrase. And such a phrase which is giving the sense, and that is nothing but we can say that the sense which is giving the, or the group of words which are giving the sense of that particular sentence, it is called as the phrase. It is called as the phrase. You can say that on a wall, it is the that particular phrase. Or in the east, it is the, you can say that phrase which is used one. So there are n number of the phrases are used one, which is giving the sense of that particular sentence. Another example we can consider that he has a coin. No doubt, everybody has a coin. He has a coin of a gold. See, everybody has a coin. We don't know which kind of a coin is there. Might be silver, might be any other thing, might be bronze. But he has a coin of a gold. That means of a gold, it is the, you can see that it is giving the entire meaning or sense, not only meaning, sense of that particular sentence. Sense of that particular sentence of a gold. Right? So such a phrase of a gold, or that particular on a wall in the east, these kind of group of words which is giving the exactly sense of that particular sentence, it is called as a phrase. So to make a proper sentence, the words, the group of words, which is giving the sense, which is also called as a phrase, these are used to build this particular sentence, which is giving the particular meaning of that particular sentence. Okay, that is the thing. Now, as consideration with the subject, with the phrase, subject in the sense, that particular sentence subject. Right? Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall, or the sun rises in the east. That means that word, words are used in that particular sentence, which is giving, which is having some sort of the subject. That means sun. Okay, sun rises. It is having the subject. Sun, what it is doing? It is rises. And where? In the east. So, sense as well as the subject, as well as the number of groups are used here to build the that particular sentence. According to that, some words which forms a part of the sentence, which contains the subject, which is predicting that particular sentence, okay, which is predicting, which is use, which is having the subject, or which is containing the subject, which is forming the that particular sentence, which is a part of that particular, that means by using the words of that particular part of that particular sentence, it is called as the clause. What the clause? Now, for example, sun rises in the east. There is a clause. Subject is also there. Predict. What it is there? We are predicting. Sun rises. Sun rises where? In the east. In the east. This is the prediction. So, every subject, every sentence, it is having the number of groups, it is having the subject, it is having the, that particular, we can say that phrases, n number of, which is giving the sense, and prediction, which, if we are combined it, it is again called as the clause. That means sentence which is built by using all these things, it is also called as the clause, which is also called as the clause. Got it? This is the some sort of the things related to the sentence. Now, the sentence directly cannot be built one. Whenever we are using or building the sentence, at that time we are using some sort of the different kinds what we can say that we are considering some sort of the classes, and these classes are called as the part of the speech. Part of the speech. Now, according to their uses, of that particular part of speeches, these again can be divided, or you can see that it is having the different types. We can say that this part of speech is having the 8 number of types. First is the noun, second is the adjective, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. These classes, these types, or you can see that whatever the part of the speech is there, by using we are building the sentence, which is giving the meaningful of that particular sentence. These are the things are there which are used one. You already studied, I think, from the that means school level, from you can say that from standard 5th onwards, you are having this particular things. You are used one, you are studied one. But once again, I am just reminding, you can say that reminding that these whatever the 8 numbers are there, part of speech are there. These are noun, adjective, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. These are used to build the sentence. Okay, for example, noun, that means to name that particular person, we are using this particular noun. That means Akbar was a great king. Now, Akbar is the, we are given some sort of the, you can see that name to that particular person, right? He is bravey boy, bravey. That is the adjective. Okay, like that, these pronoun, verbs, adverbs are used in the sentence. Okay, these part of the speech, right? These part of the speech, right, which is having the 8 number of these particular kinds or classes, these are used to build the, you can say that having the meaning or to get the exactly meaning of that particular sentence, meaningful sentence, you can say that these are used in that particular sentences. And just I give one the example like that, 8. These particular classes are used, one adverb, verb, preposition, conjunction, interjections are, these are the some sort of the things are used to build up the, you can say that these particular sentences. So, so these particular phrases, this particular part of the speech and clauses, these are building the proper sentences. Students, if you are having any doubt related to the English sentence and phrase, you can write me mail. My mail ID is the Sachin Kupade @gmail.com. Right? You can mail me if, whatever your doubts are there. Just share me that particular doubts on this particular mail. I will again divert you that particular mail, having clearing the your doubts. And I am having the notes. I will try to convert these notes in a soft copy, and I will share these notes to you people so that you will get the idea about this particular all the that related to the sentence and the related to the phrases. Now, next point we are going to discuss is the that particular second point as the analysis of you can say that sentences, complex sentences, right? Analysis